coming straight off the Warehouse Tasks episode, and we are still talking about them. I know, but I'm going to explain to you in a minute why we need to start this episode with Warehouse Tasks again. Warehouse Tasks are like people, because some people cannot be alone, and so do the Warehouse Tasks. A Warehouse Task cannot exist without another object, and this object is called Warehouse Order. But just explaining that every Warehouse Task is assigned to a Warehouse Order would be wrong, and way too easy. So let me draw a picture for you in order to understand how Warehouse Tasks and Warehouse Orders work and interact with each other. Let us assume we create Warehouse Tasks for an outbound delivery order. Someone ordered a whole lot of different items, and our warehouse needs to pick those items in order to deliver them. So the EWM triggers a stock removal strategy and searches for the different items. If those items were found, the EWM creates the picking warehouse tasks. When those tasks are created, they run through a big hopper, and this hopper combines and bundles those tasks to warehouse orders. That is the basic principle behind warehouse orders. Up to now, we just know that warehouse orders exist and that they bundle warehouse tasks, but legitimately, you might ask two questions. One being the reason for warehouse orders, and one being how that bundling is done. And you would be absolutely right about those questions, so let me answer them for you. In order to understand the reason for warehouse orders, you have to understand that EWM doesn't assign multiple warehouse tasks to resources. So in order to pick the items for an outbound delivery order, the user would have to pick each piece individually and would have no form of optimization while walking through the warehouse. If warehouse tasks are bundled to a warehouse order, the EWM optimizes all the tasks in an order in order for the user to take the least steps possible to pick all items. If there was no optimization, the user would walk crisscross through the warehouse and it would take forever to complete one delivery. The second question is how those warehouse orders bundle the warehouse tasks. Responsible for that are the so-called warehouse order creation rules. Since there are way too many customizing possibilities to explain them all, let us just play through an example. Let us assume Mr. Smith orders 10 handbags in all different shapes, colors, and sizes. The EWM now creates 10 warehouse tasks for those 10 handbags, and the user starts the picking process. But can you spot the problem? 10 handbags can never be carried by one warehouse worker. So in this case, it seems pretty useful to limit the number of items in the warehouse order, or even better, limit the warehouse order to a certain weight and volume. So for example, those 10 warehouse tasks could be split into two orders with 5 pieces each. Now the warehouse control center can send 2 warehouse workers to pick those items, and neither of them has a problem that the items are too big or too heavy to pick in one pass. So to sum it up, warehouse orders bundle warehouse tasks, and this bundling can be customized in EWM to certain warehouse or product specific attributes. The handling in the warehouse is much easier and quicker by setting up proper warehouse order creation rules.